Thank you, Jeremy. You'd be interested in this next project. A new documentary looks at how people in our area are responding to climate change. Dave Kendall with Prairie Hollow Productions is telling the story. He is here with Kathleen Bascom, the Episcopal Bishop for Kansas. Welcome to both of you.
Hello.
Dave, you're calling this Hot Times in the Heartland, and here I thought it was about the best block parties in the state. No, not so much.
Well, you could make it out of it what you like, I guess, and there are different ways to take it. Hot in terms of temperature is one of the ways which we've noticed that it happens in the summertime around here, or even this time of year. It's a little hotter than normal right now for February. And so the climate is changing, and the other aspect of hot times is that sometimes we're going to be kind of scrambling to deal with it or get out of the way or do something to try to slow the process down or adapt to it.
What was your approach in telling this story?
Well, the idea was to, this is a global situation, it's a global phenomenon, and I wanted to focus on what's happening in our part of the world. So how do you localize something like this? I focused on Northeast Kansas primarily, the Kansas River Valley into Kansas City, and I just started looking around to see who was doing something connected to it. Mm-hmm. And so we started out kind of telling the science of climate change and went on from there, like what's happening, how do we know it's happening, and then what are people doing about it?
Well, you sent us a little promotional clip for it, so let's show everyone that right now.
My friend Rex Buchanan, former director of the Kansas Geological Survey, and my wife, Laura Mead, joined me to speak with a number of different people who've shared their unique perspectives on the situation we're in. Come along with us on this journey as we explore the impact of climate change on our part of the Great Plains, looking at what's being done to help deal with the challenges posed by increasing temperatures and extreme weather events. We're facing some hot times in the Heartland. You might want to sit up and take note as we hear from some of the folks most tuned in to what's happening.
And as I watch that, Dave, there are a lot of rural scenes in there and rural communities in there, but Bishop Bascom, you are featured, and Grace Cathedral's kind of right in the heart of Topeka. So what was it that you're doing that kind of caught Dave's eye?
Well, since 1860, the Episcopal Church has had property right there. We now steward 3 acres right between Topeka High School and Grace Cathedral. We spent time listening to neighbors, constituents, and people concerned about climate change, loss of biodiversity, and said, what can we do? How can we really return what's been entrusted to us, to the people of Topeka, to the creation that we believe that God has given us that is holy by its very nature. So we have put in teaching prairie, food gardens, places for meditation. It's open to the public. We want everyone to feel welcome and come. It's also a teaching center. Through the Episcopal Church and Anglicans even globally, we are building networks of both church-owned lands, but even more importantly, people who are working on these issues. So cattle ranchers, people with urban gardens, people working on water, to build networks, to support one another, maybe even pray for one another, and learn how to take better care.
So you are in all the different environments. And it was interesting, at your Topeka garden, you actually had students in last fall to study the butterfly migration. You work with a zoo on that.
Yes. We learned that the educational folks were our greatest partners, both in need for green space. So Meadows Elementary School, they came. I think we helped them nurture 600 caterpillars into butterflies and had a great release. We grow those kind of plants there on the property, butterfly milkweed, other things.
Nice. And Dave, what is the main message you hope people take away from this documentary, which, by the way, has its premiere on Sunday, February 25th at Grace Cathedral? What is the main thing you want them to take away from viewing this?
Well, you said the operative word is hope. You said, what do I hope people to take away? And hope is one of the big ones. It's a daunting subject, and sometimes when people find out about what's going on, it's kind of depressing, and they feel like a sense of despair, there's nothing I can do. And so we want to give people a sense, no, that's not entirely true, and there are some hopeful things, and people are doing things that are positive, and that's where people like the bishop come in.
Perfect.
Where you find out what's being done to
address
it.
And real quick, if they can't make it Sunday, where will they be able to see it?
There are a number of showings coming up, screenings coming up, and we've got them all listed on our website, which is prairiehollow.net.
We will get that link on WIBW.com as well. Thank you to both of you for coming in and filling us in. Great project. You can enjoy a night of fun, twins.